want you to join me in this secret walk, beautiful area, as I explain to you what happens if a medical expert does not confirm that you have a valid basis for a medical malpractice case. Come join me for a moment as I help you understand what occurs. Hi, I'm Gerry Oginski. I'm a New York medical malpractice and personal injury attorney. All right, you know from watching my videos that in order to proceed forward with a valid medical malpractice case, we have to get a medical expert to confirm that number one, your doctor was careless, number two, that his carelessness caused you harm, and number three, that your injuries are significant or permanent. All three of those things have to be confirmed by a doctor who has either treated you or reviewed all your records. So now, let's say we gather all your medical records, and now we review them, and then we send them out to a medical expert for review. After maybe a month or so, the doctor calls us up and says, listen, we can show that the doctor was careless. What we can't show is that his carelessness was a cause of this patient's injuries. So what happens next? What happens next is I say, thank you so much. And then guess what? Now the doctor has to send me his invoice. I have to pay his bill. And then what happens after that? What happens after that, that because the doctor has confirmed that there's no valid basis for a case, it means I can't go forward. I can't bring a lawsuit on your behalf, which means I have just invested my time, my money, my effort to obtain all of your medical records and then to hire this medical expert to actually review all of the medical records. And that bill could be substantial. But it is my obligation, my responsibility to pay for that. Why? Because it is my undertaking, it is my investment to determine whether or not you have a valid basis for a case. So if the medical expert comes back and says, we only have one out of three elements that we need in order to prove a case, I have to come back to you and say, I'm sorry, I can't go forward. I can't take on your case. You'll have to try and speak to another attorney to see if they'd be willing to investigate and hire another expert to go ahead and do that. Now, you might be asking, why don't we just get another expert? Well, there comes a point in time where an attorney says, listen, I could find one expert, I could find two experts, I could find 10 experts. After the first expert, the question becomes, will the attorney go ahead and make another investment of thousands of dollars to go ahead and get your records reviewed again by a different expert? The answer is some lawyers will do that. But what about the third expert or the fourth or the fifth? At some point, the attorney is going to say, listen, I'm not making any more of an investment of my money out of my own pocket, knowing full well that there's a very low chance, if ever, that you have a valid basis for a case. In that instance, I'm going to cut my losses, say thank you very much, and tell you to please seek out another attorney right away. So why do I share this quick information with you? I share it with you just to give you a little bit of an insight into what goes on when an attorney decides to investigate your case, now goes ahead, gets your records, and then hires a medical expert to give us an opinion about whether or not you do or do not have a case. You know, I do realize you're watching this video because you have questions or concerns about your own matter. Well, if your matter happened in New York and you're thinking about bringing a lawsuit, but have not done so yet because you still have questions that need to be answered, what I invite you to do is pick up the phone and call me. You know, I answer questions like yours every single day and I'd love to chat with you. You can reach me at 516-487-8207 or by email at Gerry, G-E-R-R-Y, at oginski-law.com. That's it for today's video. I'm Gerry Oginski. Have a great day.